Shanghai GDG is a very interesting developer community.
I'm glad somebody has asked this question.
This is where the magic happens.
This is primarily a question and answer show. So if any of you out there would like to ask questions.
Hi, everyone. I'm Ali, working for the Google Drive team. And today we're going to show you how to write a complete JavaScript-based, browser-based Google Drive app. Hopefully in under 5 minutes. It's going to take a bit of copy and paste, but I'm going to take you through each of the individual steps. Now, the first thing I want to show you is our quick start page. Now, we have a quick start page for how to get up and running quickly in one of Java, Python, PHP, .NET, Ruby, JavaScript, and Go. So today we're going to be going through the JavaScript one. So that's developers.google.com/drive/quick-start. So the first step in writing any application is to go to the Google APIs console and create an API project. So I'm just going to click on Create Project, and it's going to do most of the magic for me. So as you can see, it's created a project for me, and I have to choose which Google services it's going to use. So I scroll down here and I see Drive API, and I just switch that on. So you see this selector has gone to on, and now I can start using the Drive API. So what I'll have to do is create a client ID, create a client that is suitable for use as a browser-based client. So you see it's already created a simple API access one for me, but this big blue button, create an OAuth 2 client, we click on that and I give it a name, JS Quick Start. And as you can see, it's a web application. Now, one thing I have to really make sure I do correctly here is set up an origin, because I'm only going to be testing this on localhost and it will be on port 8000. So I just need to set that up so that it knows when it's running JavaScript code that it's running in the correct container. And that's just a check. So I create that client ID and I'll leave that there, because as you see, we're going to come back to this when we need the client ID that's there. Okay, as you can see, the JavaScript origin HTTP localhost 8000 is what I've set up there. So now onto the code. Now, our quick start page has copy pastable code that you should be able to just copy paste and run. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. Obviously, it would take you more than 5 minutes to write all this code, but the idea is that once you've got it running, you really then can modify it however you like. So I'm going to take a copy of that and I'm going to put it in my directory in a file called index.html. Okay, start an editor, paste my code in, and there it is. It's all collapsed, but as you can see, it's some JavaScript embedded in some HTML. Obviously, as you get more detailed in your application, you might want to take that out into separate JavaScript files. Now, the one part I need to change is here, where it says client ID. And that's the client ID that I just created here in the API console. So I'll copy that in. And there it is. Now, those of you who have used OAuth before, you might be wondering, why do I not use a client secret? Well, client secrets are not really secret if they're in a web page. Obviously, anyone can examine the source. So for that reason, there's no point in having it. So the web-based protocol only requires a client ID. So once I've done that, I save it. And back to my shell. Now, here, where I need to run a local web server just to get it up and running, I use Python's simple HTTP server. Now, you can run Python with the minus M flag, and that just starts a server, and in this case, on port 8000. So once I've got that there, then I can browse localhost 8000 and see what happens. Now, there's a very simple application. All it does is upload a single file. But first thing I get is a pop-up to ask, to request permission. Make sure that pop-ups are allowed for your local host, because that would get blocked. The reason is this quick start, the pop-up doesn't come in response to a button or anything like that. So by default, Chrome and other browsers will block that. But when you're writing your application, probably you would put this behind a button. Click this to authorize. So I authorize there. And when I refresh my page, you see, and we'll open the API console, you'll see I've got a choose file button. So this is the entire user interface for this application. I select a file, as you can see nicely here, I've got some images ready, and that was an image of a dog. And the only feedback you get currently is in console.log. And you can see that the entire metadata for the file has been returned back here. So you may not be able to see that, but for example, the bits I set, the title, the alternate link, various information about that. The title is actually the file name, and it will have done some other cool things like MD5 checksum it for you. It's correctly identified the MIME type. So now if I look in my Google Drive, I can see that that file has now magically appeared, 0.jpg, and I look at that, and it's a beautiful picture of my neighbor's dog. And there you go. That is, in entirety, us having written a Drive app. Should we try another one? Why not? So this, well, we'll go for the same file. The other images I've got are a bit big, but that will upload. Maybe we should have called it a day at writing a single one. And there. So where do we want to go from here? Well, unfortunately, the JavaScript integration is not exactly perfect. If you have a look through some of that code, some of it is a bit nasty. And the reason for that is we don't have full support for all the types of media upload that we do for the other client libraries. So for JavaScript's case, what we're actually doing is manually creating a multipart request. And you can see the code there on the screen, and please have a look at it. It's fairly nasty. You have to create the multipart yourself. You have to create the boundaries. You have to encode into Base64 the various parts. And when that's done, so it will upload successfully. So what I suggest you do here is just copy and paste that code, put out on a function, and pretend that it's not happening like that until we get the complete different types of upload, for example, resumable upload working in JavaScript in the library. So that's JavaScript. Hopefully I've shown you that you can write a complete application for Google Drive in the browser. Now, we had no server-side work. It was completely a static HTML page, and I'm serving it using just a plain web server. Please go and check those out. This video will be part of that guide, and if you're interested in other languages, we have videos for all the other languages there. But I really recommend you try this JavaScript support. It's so strong to be able to have this application that doesn't rely on any backend framework, anything like that. Anyone can run it. Anyone can add new functionality. So that's pretty cool. Okay, thank you very much. I've been Ali. Enjoy yourselves, and good luck with your Google Drive integrations.